There we go. This is a lot better test. I got it on high. Got it on max speed. You can see the original tack can't keep up. Test it with my digital. Yeah, I'm getting 46. 47. There you go. Definitely a speed increase. 4,700 RPM. That tack can't keep up on the mill.
Alright, this is going to be a speed increase. Just a simple gear mod to the GO704. To begin with, the motor, this is the gear that come off the motor, it's a 20 tooth. I just happened to notice in the PDF manual, they list that gear number 230 as a 25 tooth. If that was the case, this thing should put out 2800 RPM, but it doesn't. So that's another discrepancy with the PDF. It's supposed to be a 1 horse motor. It's actually a 3/4 horse motor. And instead of a 25 tooth, we got a 20 tooth, but it wouldn't match up with the intermediate gear if it was a 25 tooth. The intermediate gear is plastic. It goes on that intermediate shaft where the shift gears. This is a 15 millimeter shaft. The motor shaft is 10 millimeters. Okay, I'm replacing them with metal gears. These are just plain spur gears. The originals use Helix, they're quieter, but these are a lot cheaper. This is just an experiment. I'm not gonna spend twice the money for something that's only going to be on here for a short while, because I'm ripping all that stuff out of here to put in a belt drive. So, but this little test. Ordered a gear, comes with the 10 millimeter bore, it'll fit right on there. Did have to take about 1/8 inch off the hub, and instead of going through the trouble of putting a slot in there for the keyway, I'm just using the set screw. It worked fine on my belt drive on the X2, so this is just temporary. Anyway, that'll go on here, and well, let me find it. Okay, just tightened up the set screw. Got just enough room for it to fit the Allen wrench back in, or tighten up good and tight, and that'll leave the gear prong of the head about 1/8 of an inch, the same height the motor gear should be, so they should mesh up just right. And there's already a recess cut out of the mill of the motor base from the bigger intermediate gear, so there's plenty of room in there. Alright, now I'll put it together and try her out. I'm gonna put the little grease guard back on. This will only be short term, but I just want to make sure it doesn't fling any grease over onto the tack pickup. Screw up my RPM output. That's the whole point. Let's see what kind of RPM we get here. Alright, now it's ready to go together. Alright, let's try it out.
2500 RPM. I don't think this tack in this thing can keep up. I'm going to have to get my portable one. See, it just keeps climbing and climbing, but the motor sounds the same. Well, look at me go get my digital tack and we'll find out exactly. There we go. This is a lot better test. I got it on high. Max speed, you can see the original tack can't keep up. Test it with my digital. Yeah, I'm getting 46. 47.
One problem though, that is very warm. I mean, that's almost, that is too warm to keep my hand on there. Warm there. Not really warm up here in the head. But yeah, that spindle is definitely warm. Ow! That is really warm. Don't think these things are going to handle speed increases without replacing the bearings.